Hello, curious minds. What if I told you that, according to classical physics, the entire universe should have collapsed in on itself long ago? Yet here we are, standing under a vast, seemingly stable sky. How is that possible? Why hasn't gravity pulled everything together into one giant cosmic crunch? Today, we're diving into a mystery that puzzled even Isaac Newton himself. Why hasn't gravity caused the universe to implode? Welcome to the Bentley Paradox. To understand Bentley's paradox, we first need to go back to Newton's law of universal gravitation. Newton proposed that every object with mass in the universe exerts a gravitational force on every other object. The strength of this force depends on two things, their masses and the distance between them. Newton described this with a simple equation. The force of gravity between two objects is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. In other words, the more massive two objects are, the stronger the gravitational pull between them. And the closer they are, the stronger that force becomes. But here's where things get interesting. Newton's law of gravity doesn't have any limits. It applies everywhere, at every distance, and at every point in the universe. Gravity doesn't just stop after a certain range, it extends infinitely. So, in principle, everything in the universe is gravitationally connected, no matter how far apart objects are. At the same time, Newton and many of his contemporaries believed in the idea of an infinite universe. They imagined the universe as stretching out endlessly in all directions. This concept of an infinite static universe was quite common at the time, and it made sense based on what they could observe. This infinite universe was thought to be stable and unchanging, and for a while this seemed like a satisfying view of the cosmos. But combining Newton's law of gravity with the concept of an infinite universe set the stage for a major puzzle. If gravity acts between all objects and the universe is infinite, how do we explain the overall behavior of all this matter? And why does the universe appear to be stable, rather than collapsing under its own gravity? These questions led to what became known as Bentley's paradox, a problem that would challenge the very foundations of Newtonian physics. Now that we understand the basics of Newtonian gravity and the idea of an infinite universe, let's explore the puzzle itself. Bentley's paradox is surprisingly simple, but it presents a huge problem for the idea of an infinite, static universe. Here's the paradox in a nutshell. If the universe is filled with matter and extends infinitely in all directions, then every object in the universe should be pulling on every other object through the force of gravity. Gravity is always attractive, and it doesn't have a limit on how far it can reach. So if you have an infinite number of stars or galaxies, they should all be pulling on each other. And over time, this attraction should cause all the matter in the universe to clump together. This leads to a very logical conclusion. The entire universe should collapse under the weight of its own gravity. So why doesn't this happen? Richard Bentley pointed this out in a famous letter to Isaac Newton. He asked, essentially, why hasn't gravity caused the universe to implode if there's no end to the amount of matter pulling in all directions? It was a brilliant question that highlighted a flaw in Newton's own model of the universe. In other words, the universe should collapse into a single point, a gravitational catastrophe where everything is pulled into one gigantic mass. But clearly the universe isn't collapsing. It appears stable, at least on large scales. When Bentley raised his paradox, Newton was faced with a serious challenge. How could his law of universal gravitation be correct if an infinite universe filled with matter should collapse under its own weight? Newton's response was careful and, for its time, quite clever. Newton proposed that, in an infinite universe, gravity might balance out. He suggested that if the universe stretched infinitely in all directions, the gravitational pull from distant stars and galaxies could cancel out, holding everything in place. In other words, for every star pulling in one direction, there could be an equal and opposite pull from stars in the opposite direction, creating a kind of cosmic equilibrium. This idea seemed like a neat solution. If gravity were pulling equally in all directions, then no single part of the universe would be dragged in any one direction, and the universe could remain static and unchanging. But there was a problem. Newton's response assumed that this perfect balance could exist indefinitely. However, even a slight disturbance in this balance would throw everything off. Essentially, Newton's response didn't fully solve Bentley's paradox. Even if gravitational forces could be balanced, the universe would still be on the brink of collapse. And beyond that, Newton's explanation left another key question unanswered. Why would the universe be perfectly balanced in the first place? What mechanism could ensure this delicate equilibrium? While Newton's attempt was impressive for his time, it left physicists with a nagging sense that the problem was far from solved. The idea of a stable, infinite, and static universe just didn't fit with the laws of gravity. And as we would later discover, the universe isn't static at all, it's expanding. But that realization wouldn't come for centuries when new discoveries would finally give us a clearer answer. For centuries, there wasn't a satisfying answer to this paradox, until Albert Einstein's theory of general relativity came along in 1915 and changed everything. Instead of thinking of gravity as a force that acts between masses across space, Einstein proposed that gravity is a result of the curvature of space-time itself. Massive objects like stars and planets cause the fabric of space-time to curve, and this curvature tells objects how to move. The greater the mass, the greater the curvature, and the stronger the gravitational effect. This shift in thinking was profound. In Einstein's universe, gravity isn't a force that reaches out across empty space. It's the very shape of space that changes in the presence of mass. But what does this have to do with Bentley's paradox and the idea of an infinite universe? One of the key insights from general relativity is that the universe doesn't have to be static. In fact, Einstein himself initially believed the universe was static, but his own equations suggested otherwise. When he applied general relativity to the entire universe, Einstein found that the equations predicted a dynamic, evolving universe, one that could either expand or contract but not stay perfectly still. This idea was initially unsettling to Einstein, who introduced a term called the cosmological constant into his equations, essentially a fudge factor to counterbalance gravity and keep the universe static. He believed that without this constant, the gravitational attraction of all the matter in the universe would cause it to collapse, just like Bentley's paradox predicted. But this turned out to be a mistake. In the 1920s, the astronomer Edwin Hubble made a groundbreaking discovery. The universe wasn't static at all. It was expanding. By observing distant galaxies, Hubble found that they were moving away from us, and the farther they were, the faster they were receding. This observation gave rise to the concept of the expanding universe, which finally offered a solution to the problem of Bentley's paradox. In an expanding universe, there's no need for a perfect balance of forces to prevent collapse. The expansion counteracts the pull of gravity. Instead of everything drawing together into a single point, the fabric of space itself is stretching, pushing galaxies apart. The gravitational forces are still there, but they're not enough to stop this expansion. In fact, general relativity showed that the fate of the universe depends on its overall density. If the universe has enough matter, gravity could eventually slow the expansion down and cause a future collapse, leading to a big crunch. But if there isn't enough matter, the universe will continue expanding forever, eventually reaching a cold, dark, and distant state. Einstein's theory, combined with Hubble's discovery of the expanding universe, provided the final answer to Bentley's paradox. The universe didn't need to be static and perfectly balanced to avoid collapse, because it wasn't static at all. Instead, it was expanding, and that expansion solved the gravitational instability that Newtonian physics couldn't explain. In the end, Einstein called his addition of the cosmological constant the biggest blunder of his career, but his equations, without that constant, turned out to describe the universe better than he ever imagined, offering a framework for understanding not only gravity, but the evolution of the cosmos itself. With general relativity, Bentley's paradox no longer posed a problem. As we wrap up our discussion on Bentley's paradox, it's clear that this idea played a crucial role in shaping our understanding of the universe. Bentley challenged the way we thought about gravity and the infinite universe, which pushed scientists to rethink their ideas. His questions helped lead to Einstein's theory of general relativity, changing our view of gravity from a force between objects to the curvature of space and time itself. Bentley's paradox also helped us understand that the universe is expanding, not just sitting still. This opened the door to concepts like dark matter and dark energy, which are vital to explaining how our universe works. In short, Bentley's paradox reminds us that the universe is full of surprises, and the more we learn, the more we realize how much more there is to discover. So, while Bentley's paradox has been resolved by our modern understanding of an expanding universe, it leaves us wondering, what other mysteries of the cosmos might still be waiting for us to solve? Could dark energy or the possibility of a multiverse hold even deeper paradoxes we've yet to uncover? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. If you enjoyed unraveling this cosmic mystery with me, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe so you don't miss the next deep dive into the wonders of space and time. Thanks for watching. Until next time, keep looking up.